Hi, I'm Helena Post and welcome to Spun Out Post Studio down in the back cave. I just wanted to do a little video showing you what I've done in the last month. I've been quite productive using my fibre as therapy. So over here. Oh, and no, actually, you stay there. Okay. Over here. So like I made that beautiful magenta hat. That was like a turban-y kind of thing, and it got me thinking about what it would look like to make a turban-y kind of thing with two kind of horn-like projections. So I made this, which I absolutely adore. It has this like crisscross over the front, and it kind of hangs. Like so, I imagine you can kind of get some kind of dance routine happening with these. And I'll just come up close and show you. I think it's rather splendid. And the tail is crochet over roving, and I have the ends sticking out. So you can kind of have it wrapped around like so you got two horns, which is bizarre. You can just have it hanging. You can use these as a scarf. I love it. Very versatile, lots of things to play with. But that's not all. I have a very dear friend who like the idea of that magenta turban, so I made one for her and I had a bit left over, so I made this shoulder wrap to go with it, which I just love. And this is just the one spout again, goes like so. And you can have that kind of down or at the back or however you'd like. And then there's this rather spectacular scarf tail. I love it. That goes over the top. I don't know if you can see the detail, but the roving is sticking out and it's just, oh, I love this. I'll come a bit closer. So you can see, I love the colours too, crocheting over the top of the roving, it's very beautiful. So there's that one. So that's two hats. I've also been working on this big spider web thing. I've got going from black to grey and I'm into the white now. I can't work out whether I'm going to turn that into a labyrinth, so you hang it up and it drapes down. Here's all my yarn down here that I spun for it, or whether I want to make it something that hangs and has a whole heap of chains like a shower, so you can, I'm still working on that one. So I've been working on that. I made another hat called the Frisian. Well, it's another version of the Frisian. And that one can be worn in very many ways. So what I like about this, so it's woven. It's all been woven and then I've wrapped the wire, this wire to hold its shape with raw fleece and yarn and then crocheted it. So we've got weaving and crochet, which I love. And I made that on this beautiful circular loom from Made Craft. Absolutely divine. It's almost like one of those drums. And then I had photos on Instagram of this one. I wove a big blanket that felt like it was weaving a landscape of beautiful colours, and I made a hat to go with it. Very fine and even spun on sock needles. So there's a hat and a blanket. It's beautiful. You can see the colours. Love that. And then I made this piece of weaving. I have photos of this too. This is Divine Colours. And I was thinking of turning, like making exactly two of these, the same colour and size, and then crocheting a panel up the back and crocheting another thin strip of weaving as a hood and put it so big cloak. So I was thinking of doing that. That is another very beautiful dye job, and the weaving this was just divine. And I also made this rather very long and very loosely woven, and I've put the warp in every second. I'll show you. Every second, so it's really loose. Every second warp space, massively loose. Hang on, that's two layers. So if I do one layer, you can really see. It's amazing, I love it. And I've made this the same length as this piece of roving, and I was going to crochet that to the roving, so you'd have this massive long kind of feather boa number. So that's been fun. And I got asked a question by a woman on Instagram, and she asked me what got me into weaving and why I started weaving, and it got me thinking. And really, to be honest, I got into weaving because I got a spinning wheel. My mum gave me a spinning wheel when I was 30, and I started spinning, and when I spun I had a yarn, and when I had a yarn I wanted to do something beautiful with it. So all this stuff that's around me right now, from the Puss Andry to this little, all of it was made because I had a yarn. And when your hands spin a yarn, it's not perfectly even 8-ply, so there's no point going out to get patterns. So I had to work things out that I could do with it so I could keep spinning, because I loved spinning. So I've only been weaving for like a couple of years, and I absolutely, like, I just want to see my yarns in as many different situations as I possibly can. And one last thing before we go. I made this one earlier. I made this as a whip because my girls were learning to ride on these wild ponies and they needed a lunging whip. But check it out if you listen. It's got a wool whip, a wool crack. And since making it for its very serious purpose of lunging, I found out that Tamasicus, this is like the cruelest kind of whip you could have, because it looks like it'll hurt and it doesn't. I think that's really cute. So I just had to show you what I've been making this month. It's all therapy, of course. We're in Brisbane unexpectedly, and this is like heavily been my therapy at the moment. And this is what I've made this month. Now, if you like me vlogging, and if you want me to do more, can you like and subscribe? And because I'd love to keep going. I'm getting there. I'm working my way up to it anyway. Thank you for coming.